your DIVA'S mix platform where we get to talk and say what we want, when we want, the way we want it.
That's correct.
So Ms. Marilyn, how you doing?
I'm good. Mercedes, and yourself?
Fabulous.
Do you know it's going to be Mother's Day pretty soon, in the next couple of days?
I know.
Isn't that amazing?
Marilyn, for me, Mother's Day is celebrated by the masses once a year.
Right.
But trust me, I am a mother every single day since I have my first child more than 32 years ago. So Mother's Day to you all, you can celebrate it once a year if you'd like. But to me, I celebrate Mother's Day every day.
That's true. Yeah. But the funny thing about Mother's Day is going out to dinner.
Oh.
The lines.
Oh.
Ugh.
And this year's going to be good.
Yeah, it's going to be, it's like a reunion this year.
Exactly, exactly, yes. Exactly. By the way, you guys, don't forget that we're not wearing a mask because we have both been vaccinated.
Right.
We both had both of our vaccines. And according to the CDC, if you have been vaccinated, it is okay to gather with your loved ones or even strange ones without having to wear a mask. So, kudos to us.
That's correct, yep. My daughter was telling me that in Maryland, Governor Hogan said it's okay not to wear your mask outdoors also. So it's getting around.
Yeah,
it's
I heard that too.
Yes.
But somehow, for some reason, I'm still wearing my mask. I feel like, first of all, it camouflages me. Right? Sometimes I was like, let me just wear my mask because I don't want people to know who I am.
Wear your mask and your hat.
Exactly.
Nobody knows who you are. You can go rob a bank.
Ooh. And then also, I feel like, do you remember initially they were telling people to wear their masks? People, please wear your mask, wear your mask.
Mm-hmm.
And people were hesitant to wear their mask.
Yes.
It was as if, oh, you can't tell me what to do. No, I mean, I used to go to the city. I went to the city back in May and June, and even July of last year. And you'd get in the elevators, and some people were not wearing a mask, and then you'd be wearing your mask. And then you'd go in the streets, and there were many people that were not wearing their masks.
Yes.
Right?
Uh-huh.
You're told to do something, and you're not doing it. Because you don't want to listen to the government, to the governor. Now, they're telling you it's okay not to wear your mask, and you go outside. I see more people wearing their mask now that is almost okay, and this pandemic is almost, It's almost controlled.
Yes.
Than I did before when it was all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
People, you is crazy.
And then again, the good thing with the mask right now is for the pollen. But it helps you with the pollen, all that stuff going into your nose.
So you should continue to wear your mask.
It's going to help you with the pollen. Yes.
Marilyn, you know, you are a good nurse.
Why
you say that? I'm going to tell you that because I remember every single year during the month of like March and April, I suffer from allergies.
See?
I'm always sneezing. This year,
I did not feel it. The mask. Keep wearing your mask.
Of course I'm wearing it.
Yes.
You know,
especially out there, the high pollen count.
That is
gonna
so good
you,
one.
Yeah.
Seriously,
yeah.
I have not felt any. I wonder how many people would also say that they too didn't experience the allergic reaction to the pollen this year. It's a good one.
Yeah.
There's some people who feel it in the eyes.
Correct.
But if you inhale all that pollen, it's all over.
Yeah, it's even worse.
Yeah.
Whew. And at least you know with the eyes, you can always get eye drops over the counter and keep your eye moist.
Yeah.
Don't love to get dry. Get artificial tears. It helps with the redness and everything.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
I never, like, I'm the kind of person that I don't like all that stuff. I feel like if there are things that happen to me naturally, like pollen and stuff like that, when it goes away, then mine should go away. So I'm not one to
use that drug. But just in the event, you find someone with really red eyes, you can, get some artificial tears, this time, the itchy, that kind of stuff.
Okay. So what happened to you this week, my dear? Not enough about the mask and the pollen and everything else. What happened to you this week?
I have a good story.
A very annoying story, but whatever.
Yeah, tell me what happened. I didn't do anything outstanding this week. I did more walking than usual, exercising.
Mm-hmm.
So that was good.
Mm-hmm.
It was beautiful weather for that. So I did a little bit of that, which is good for me.
A little more of
that. Yeah, a little more of that. Yeah.
Nice. That's very nice.
Yeah. But tell me your story. Tell me about the doctor's office.
That I text you really annoying. Actually, that's one other stories. I'll tell you that one instead. That was my dentist office.
Yeah.
That I had the appointment for 4 o'clock.
Uh-huh.
No, I had the appointment for 4:30,
uh-huh.
And they told me to come there at 4 o'clock. They actually called me to let me know that I should be there 30 minutes earlier. And I was a little bit upset because, wow, I scheduled my work, etc., so that I could leave and be there for 4:30. They're going to call me and tell me to be there 30 minutes earlier. And it was a little bit, like, I was annoyed, but I did it anyway.
Right.
Okay, so I said, okay, no problem, I'll be there, because, you know, you got to be nice to these people, especially since they're going to be messing around with your mouth.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. In any event, so I plan, I get there early, I go there, and I'm talking to the lady, and she gives me this form to fill out. Granted, this is not my very first time in the office, but I had to fill out this form, and I said, I've been here before. It's just that because of COVID, et cetera, I just haven't been here in the last year and a half or so. So she says, oh, but you have to fill this out anyway. No problem. So I fill out all my whole history, medical, family, et cetera. I fill it out. And then she gives me a form so that I should fill out about this COVID, because not everybody has you fill out this form about the COVID and so on.
Yes, yeah.
No problem.
Mm-hmm.
Fill everything out. And then she says, okay, now can you put your name here and your telephone number here? So I was like, okay. I said, what is that for? She says, oh, so that we can call you. I said, you're going to call me? She said, yes, you put your information and then you go out in your car and we'll call you when they're ready for you. So I signed printed my name, didn't sign it, printed my name, put my phone number, went to my car, and I'm sitting in my car. Don't forget, my appointment was
4 o'clock.
4:30. They told me to come at 4.
Right.
So I go to my car, and I'm sitting down, 4:40. I'm still waiting for my phone call, 4:45. I'm waiting for my phone call. I'm like, damn. Okay. It was almost 5 o'clock when they called me. So now I go in, and I sit down at the dentist chair. Now, I'm waiting another 10 minutes, Marilyn, for somebody to come and check my mouth and do the x-rays, etc. So I sit down, this young lady, very nice young lady, we're talking, etc. She did my x-rays. Then she says, the dentist will be here with you shortly. Okay, I'm sitting down. I'm waiting some more time for the dentist. Dentist shows up. He's like, now it's after 5. And I'm thinking, wow. So the dentist comes and he does his thing. To me, it's like, why would you, like, my time is valuable. I know that your time is valuable and you have a DR in front of your last name, but my time is valuable too. Seriously. So that was my annoying doctors. Whoever you are, if you have a chance to listen to this video, and I hope that you do, just know that it is insanely annoying for you to schedule somebody, all your people up front, whoever it is, to schedule somebody for a particular time, and they're going to wait a whole 45 minutes, sometimes even more, before they see somebody. That is annoying. So, good news, I have no cavities. Hey!
Oh, that's good. That's good news.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, I got my teeth cleaned. Uh-huh. They didn't polish my teeth because they said COVID, though they didn't give me a discount because they didn't polish it, but because it's a pain.
But I know the doctor's offices and a lot of offices are so happy that now you can't bring a relative with you. So they don't have to do, if you're complaining about the service, nobody knows. You just have to sit in your car and wait.
Yeah, well, I'm complaining. People, can y'all complain for me? It's really annoying. It's really, really, really annoying.
So sometimes COVID has its benefits for the doctor's office because, you know, nobody can wait in the waiting room. You don't have to hear from the family complaining. You know.
And they're very busy.
Yeah.
They said they're very, very busy.
Yeah. But it's better for us.
What's better?
We're all being protected. We don't have to sit, you know, you're outside, you're not exposed to a whole lot of people and so on.
Yeah, but still. I mean, we've been protected, we are protected, but the fact that they're messing with our time is what I don't appreciate. Mm-hmm. I have things to do, places to go, people to talk to, and people to see. Yo, my life, gotta go.
Yeah. So what's your plan for this week?
What am I doing this week? This week, I have a few garments that I have to make for somebody.
Uh-huh. How was your postal story? Anything else happened? Did you hear anything else?
Oh, they're so full of shit.
Nothing. Did you hear nothing yet?
Nope. My package is lost, and I can't claim it, which is total package is lost. That's the story where mm-hmm. they said that they delivered a package, and I didn't receive it, and I went to them, and I told them, you said that you delivered it, but I didn't receive it, and they said they're going to do an investigation. They did the investigation. Supposedly, that was an investigation that didn't even take them 30 minutes, but they said that they did an investigation, and according to their records, it showed that the mailman delivered it, but I never got it, and I'm still waiting for it. So I called them, and they tell me that I should call the people who shipped it. What do they have to do with it when your records are showing that you supposedly shipped it, and that they supposedly delivered it? Long story short, forget about it.
They should give you some kind of credit or something.
Only God will give you credit, because they claim that they delivered it. The supplier shipped it, gave it to them, and they said that they delivered it. I never got it. It's probably at the mailman's house somewhere. He probably has a stack of stuff. You know, there was a case years ago when the mailman wasn't delivering packages.
Yeah.
And it's not like the package was stolen, because we are in a pretty safe neighborhood. There's things that they deliver, and we have cameras. There's nothing on the camera, nothing that says that anybody came and took anything. Mm-hmm. Whatever is delivered, the camera shows when they're there. But this one package was supposedly put in the mailbox.
Anyway, I never heard.
Yeah. Girl, I'd be talking. What about you? What are you doing this weekend? How's your nursing, your coaches?
Oh, my nurse. My nurse. Transformative nurse coaching.
How's it going?
It's going good. And there's so much to learn, but it's really a change in your lifestyle.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
It's mind, body, and spirit.
Okay.
So I'm learning a lot. I'm learning so much because I have the time now to really focus on it, to see how much I've been missing with my patients and so on.
Okay.
So I'm looking forward to meeting a lot of people and helping a lot of people.
Perfect.
And teaching a lot of people.
Good.
How important lifestyle is and your day-to-day activity really influence well-being.
Good. I'm sure many will benefit from your service and your help, your experience.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because you have insane credentials, so I'm excited.
But the service, I'm here to serve.
Good.
So I'm looking
forward
to that.
Be careful with the word serve, because you're not serving for free. You expect to be compensated somehow. So your service, you're not serving.
Yeah.
You're here to help.
Yes.
When you help, is it free too? We got to figure out a way to put it. Because you're going to have to get paid for your work.
Yeah. Eventually. Right now I'm doing pro bono. Okay. I'm helping for free. Since I'm learning, I'm still in class, still doing classes.
Mm-hmm.
But then the billing starts when I graduate. The money comes in then.
So if anybody wants help, get it for free now.
Yeah, get it for free now. Get it for free.
Good. I'm excited for you. Excited for you. So well, maybe next week we could talk about other things.
And
the other thing that happened to me this week that I didn't talk about, but I'll talk about it. Because I got so many stories and so many things. But people don't have time to listen to us for that long. You guys, thanks for listening for a little bit.
Yeah, and it's true.
Yeah. Anywho, girl, thank you so much. It's been so wonderful talking again. Yeah. I don't get to see you that often, but once a week that I see you, it's nice to catch up.
You should. Oh, tell me, how was your grandson this week? I know you kept him for
fabulous.
One day.
OMG.
He made your day.
He's
made
my
your
little
week.
Chief. He's my little prince, and he's got the best smile. I love that little one. My bundle of joy. And I squeeze him, and he cuddles so well. I love him. Love him.
And you know he's making you look more and more youthful.
Am I?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
What makes
you
say
look
that?
Really good. Your eyes.
Maybe it's the makeup.
Very bright. No, I don't think so. No, I've been saying for years it's not the makeup.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh,
you look really good.
Hey.
I
thank
think
you
it's
so
your grandson.
Much. Really?
That one day with him makes a big difference.
I love that little one. I love it.
Yes.
I love it.
Makes a big difference.
I love it. Cool.
Yeah. So
say goodbye to everybody.
Yeah, bye. Nice talking to you. See you soon.
Bye, guys. And do not forget, so where women don't like to be shared, this is a platform that we'd like for you to share.
Yep.
So share us, like us, follow us, watch us, talk about us, engage with us. Until the next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Have a great Mother's Day, mothers.
Oh, yeah.
Bye.
Happy Mother's Day every day, especially that day that everybody likes to do so.